are you all this evening? I am well. We are so excited to have you guys here so you can see what your kids can do.
So as we begin, can you please bow your heads and close your eyes for opening prayer? Dear God, thank you for this day. Thank you for blessing and keeping us safe and bringing us to this amazing weekend. Please help that you work through this weekend and work through the hearts of the parents, the teachers, staff, students, work through everybody's heart and help everybody draw nearer to you, God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Okay, I'm gonna ask you guys to do a favor. Not right now, but after service. If you guys can remember. So how many of you guys have Instagram? Raise your hand. Instagram. Okay. So Andres and I, we are the Spiritual Life Program Managers. And so Spiritual Life would like to ask you if you can go to Spiritual Life Instagram, which is PFA Spiritual Life, and if you can go check out the video that was posted, I think, this morning today. It's kind of like a segue from Week of Prayer, which was last week, into Parents Weekend. So we're gonna ask you guys to go check that out. It's kind of funny. We are just so excited to have you all here. Just to see what we can do, because we love you all and we want to show you all how much we appreciate you and what your investment at Pine Forge Academy, what that is growing.
Like you've heard, Week of Prayer, we've come from an action-packed week, and we're leading you into an even more action-packed weekend with items from creative arts, which you will see today, poetry, choir, which you will see tomorrow, and even something new tomorrow night.
So tonight, like he said, CA will be performing, and we are just so excited to have them here, and we're excited to have you all here. Thank you all for coming, and we hope that you have a blessed night. Welcome to Parents Weekend Fall 2023. Happy Sabbath!
Good evening, everyone. Can I get a louder? Good evening, everyone. So my name is Toko Zani Kulameka, and I'm from the class of 27. And today, we're gonna be doing praise and worship. So don't stay sitting down. Everybody get up and worship with us, because that's what we're here to do. Something we cannot explain that happened.
Power in the name of Jesus.
So much power.
Power in the name.
There is power in the name.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
So much power.
Power in the name.
Say things change when I call you.
Things change when I call you, Jesus. Things change when I call your name.
Things change.
Standing here,
Weekend, first one for 2023-24. Thank you so much for coming out. My name is Martine Erica Birmingham. I'm the proud and humble director of Creative Arts Ministry. Crazy. Now, this year, we've already left, guys, guys, I'm about to start. So we've left campus several times. Amen. Yes. So yeah, the rumor is real. We are officially touring. Amen. Yes. tremendously blessed us over and over and over again. So give it up for Jed. You're acting like this? Y'all ignoring me? You know what? This is disrespectful. What's going on?
Guess who's coming?
Who?
Jesus.
When?
Now.
Right now?
Right now.
Go get ready. Let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our first poet, Miss Marie Michelle Desire.
Welcome in, God, to my family, my kin. Welcome to erase all of my sin. Bring us back to the pureness that should have been, but one room. That's all that's reserved for you. Okay, God, that should be okay, right? Please make do. It is us that you made. So don't allow us to be something the devil takes. Ding dong. Knock, knock, but one room, that's all reserved. Please, ding dong, knock, knock, that's all reserved for you. I wonder who's behind the door, what entails behind the door. Let's see. Oh no, it's somebody that fills our mind with gore. He comes in uninvited, tears up our family. But where is God? Out of mind, out of sight. But what happened? We gave him one room. Not a mop nor broom, but we gave him one room. A whole room. In turn, please don't let us go to ruin. Knock, knock, ding dong. Who's at the door? Go get the door. Click, swish. Oh no, he's here again. Oh God, please do what you do. We gave you two this time, two rooms just for you. Ding dong, knock, knock, swish, swish. He's here, he's ruined us. My God, why have you forsaken me? We gave you two rooms. You were supposed to make do. Why are we in ruin for all that we gave you? And God says, give me all. Welcome me in. For I cannot do that much with half a room, one room, or two rooms, but give me all. Welcome me in. Give me your entire, your whole, so I can protect you, so I can love you. One room. Two rooms, not three rooms, but the whole house reserved for me. So nobody can take my spot. So I might fight against. Welcome in. Welcome in. The spot reserved for me.
From the class of 2025. Once upon a time, during the Thanksgiving season, a huge family decided to get together like most families. Now, the first family we see consists of father number one, mother number one, son number one, and daughter number one. Let's listen in on their conversation.
Thank you.
introduce family number two. And together they all say,
Happy Thanksgiving.
We have father number two, mother number two.
What in the world?
Son number two, and daughter number two. And daughter number two. Let's do it again. Father number two, wife number two, son number two, and daughter number two. Let's listen in on their interaction.
Oh, Matthew, how you been?
Good, what's up,
bud?
I understand. Oh, Mr. Rose, I'm here. Oh,
please, can I get a hug? No. I still love you just like your mother would cry.
What do you mean she's just like the book?
No, I'm sorry, brother-in-law, but the whole thing me and your wife got in common is DNA.
Over there anyway.
Hey, cuz.
My mother disowned me. My father, he can't even look at me. They are embarrassed of me. I weep and they tell me that I'm weak. And it's so much better to stay quiet, better to push it to the backside, better to leave it all behind, because I'm too much for them to handle. And so I do nothing, say nothing, see nothing, feel nothing. I'm too much to handle. So when the secrets swimming in my heart begin to overflow, the eyes I've closed sting with tears, and the mouth I've shut yearns to scream. Too much for him to handle. In fact, he wants it. Don't sugarcoat it. Pick up your cross and follow him. He wants it all. Not only the joy, he wants it all. Not only the patience, peace, and kindness, he wants it all. You're faking and you're fronting. But you don't have to do it in front of Jesus. He already knows.
Amen.
Just let him in. Give him the keys to your house.
Thank you.
through the hands of God himself, he gives us all self-worth. We all have the choice to choose what's right because he gave us all free will. For if you choose the things of this world, you will surely roll downhill. You will land in a hole that you can't get out, no matter how hard you try. And no one will be able to help you out, no matter how hard you may cry. There is only one way out of this hole, on a path that is very thin. You must surrender your life to Jesus Christ, and he'll forgive all your sins. He will set your feet on solid ground. He will help you walk uphill. He will show you how to choose what's right, and he'll show you his own will. When we keep our eyes on Jesus, God's only begotten Son, everything comes in second, for the Lord is number one.
And the next morning, Jesus resumes his spot on the couch, awaiting his children's arrival once again, but this time, oh, they mad. They real mad.
Can they show him for him to understand that they're willing to give him their all? He shows up, excited, thinking the house is his.
Oh man, a house without Jesus. Pretty cool.
Hey Satan.
Yeah. What are you still doing here?
Oh, I live here.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
children. I've enjoyed my stay, but I must leave.
Aww.
Oh, and before I forget, here are the keys back.
No, Jesus. I have spare keys. Come with me.
I appreciate it, my son. Well, I must go.
Bye, Jesus.
All right, guys.
Hey, Jesus.
Stay safe.
When will I see you again?
Soon, my child.
Amen. And the Holy Spirit comes upon them, and their hearts are changed.
Absolutely. This was completely improv. Give it up for these actors and writers. Give it up. Improv. And by the way, guys, when did we start this? On Tuesday. Because we are not accustomed to touring. Give it up for the choir and Mr. Rose Royale. So we are learning a different style of theater. Listen, we like to compartmentalize God. And as an adult, I do the same thing. Lord, I trust you with my 10%, not with my offering, because I don't know what the church is going to do with it. God said it's still mine. Or Lord, I finally trust you with my money, but I don't trust you with my brokenness, or with my addictions, or with anything else. But God says he wants what?
Oh.
He wants it all. And so that is our message. We thank you so much for paying attention. We thank you so much for being here. Finally, we are
Creative Arts Ministry.
God bless you. She was one of my actors. She's now one of the choir singers. She's part of Spiritual Life. Give it up for Chap. Coming now. Give it up for Chap. Hold it. So this is Week of Prayer, right? Give it up for our speaker for this evening from the class
of 2020, Nazaya Romano. Part of the class of 2025. If I could be a bit transparent with you guys, I'm a bit nervous. But you know, if someone were to ask me a good 4 years ago to preach, I'd probably laugh because I would think this is not for me. But by the grace of God, it's my third year at Pine Forge Academy, and I'm preaching my third sermon. Not only in front of the student body, but student body and family. So, you know, God has a funny way of working, and I'm just so glad. It would be a lie if I were to say that I'm not nervous, but I am. And I'd really love to be like my influencers. You guys know Pastor Snail, Kimberly Mann, Miss Claudia, and Chad,
but I have to realize that they all have been through a process and journey, and that, you know, it's going to take time. So I hope you guys can be patient with me and be a part of my journey as I'm trying to be a minister for Christ. May everyone stand in respect of the word, please. Okay, so today we'll be coming from the text, Genesis 22, 1 verse 5, and say amen when you get there. The Bible says,
sometime later, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, here I am, he replied. Then God said, take your son, your only son, whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you. Early the next morning, Abraham got up and loaded his donkey. He took with him two of his servants and his son Isaac. When he had cut enough wood for the burnt offering, he set out for the place God had told him about. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place in the distance. He said to his servant, stay here with the donkey while I and the boy go over there. We will worship and then we will come back to you. Today, I will be speaking under the sermonic title, Let the Author Write. Let us pray. Dearly Father, thank you, Lord, for bringing us all here today. Thank you for giving everyone in here travel mercies, Lord. Continue to be with every person in here, Lord. Allow me to be a vessel to give your word. Allow me to just be able to, you know, release the nerves and know that you are in control and using me to give the word, Lord. I'm asking you to bring your Holy Spirit upon this church, Lord, as I give the word today. And let it touch at least one ear in this room at this moment. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This story has been told many times. But when reading into it and digesting every verse, I can imagine it's hard for you not to dive into what Abraham must have been thinking at the time. God, you must be joking, or there's no way you're making me do this. And the amount of faith and serenity that had to be going on in the moment. What the text is suggesting is that sometimes you need to surrender to God so he can be able to establish his plans for your life. I want to know by a show of hands how many of you would take your child and have them as a burnt offering if God told you to. So, one thing I know for sure, if God said to my mother to take your daughter, Isaiah, and offer her as a burnt offering, she would without a doubt. Because one thing about my mother, she is so locked in with God that she knows that whatever God is asking of her is for her good. And it's nothing bad that's going to come out of it. I don't know if you guys realize the amount of surrendering to God it takes to sit there and wake up the next morning and take your child to kill as a burnt offering. He didn't even like try to pretend with God, oh, God, I woke up late. He said, oh, I'm going to wake up and do what God told me to do today. He didn't even try to act out anything. He said, God, you told me to do this. I'm going to wake up. And I have realized that as time goes on, it's been harder to surrender to God. The more I see people trying to create their own narrative and own story, we hate to feel the feeling of being unsure. So we take things into our own hands, not knowing when the next check will come in, not knowing how I will pay for the next tuition bill, or even how I'm going to make it throughout the end of the year. I have a question for you guys. What if life was never meant to worry about what God already has in control? Some of us are trying to provide like God, but God is the real provider. Yeah. Some of us are trying to be the waymaker like God, but the problem is that we are not God. God is the waymaker. Abraham did not know what God was doing in his life. He didn't have the A to Z about what was going to happen after his son was killed, or why was he even killing his son in the first place. But what did he say? Here I am. When Abraham said that to God, not only was his eyes and ears open to whatever God had to say, but he was able to surrender to God and to do whatever he had to say to do to him. It says that Abraham rose up and were early about what God asked of him. This shows his obedience to God without questioning, even if he lacked understanding. I'm heavy on showing that I'm surrendering, showing it, Abraham, due to the fact that I need you to understand what it takes to allow God to be the author.
Okay.
It is no accident that the Bible says that he is the author.
It doesn't say that we are the co-writers with him. So, suggesting that only he has the ability to develop our faith. I'm sorry to say it, but trying to put the puzzles together in your life without God would not work. Sometimes it's not meant for us to put them together. Step by step and day by day, things will be revealed. We tend to try to do God's job from him when that's what he never intended us to do. Don't wonder why stress, depression, and anxiety exist among us. We allow uncertainty to take over us when God is already in the process of writing our story. In the Bible, it said, I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. In Jeremiah 1, verse 9. This means he knows the beginning and the end of everything in your lives. We need to start walking in faith rather than feelings. Can we imagine how it would have been if Abraham walked in feelings? And truth be told, I think some of us haven't even registered that our feelings have become our God. Simply because we find ourselves following the directions of men opposed to the direction of God himself.
I hear you.
Abraham said God has provided the lamb for the burnt offering. But where's the lamb? What lamb could Abraham possibly be speaking about? Abraham has trusted that God will provide him with the lamb. Abraham was trusting God to provide something that didn't even exist for him yet. Something I find amazing reading the text in verse 5, it says, he said to his servant, stay here with this donkey while I and the boy go over there. We will worship and then we will come back to you. If you don't realize what Abraham said, he said, we will come back to you. This shows that Abraham wasn't expecting to leave without Isaac. He knew and stood firm on his belief that Isaac was going to return with him. Also believed that God would keep his promise to him. Many of us, when God tells us to do something or when we are in a difficult situation, it's a little hard to do. We don't do it because you possibly cannot see the goodness that will come out of it. You can't perceive your situation the same way God can. We prevent ourselves from blessings. What if we were to be more like Abraham and go do what God told us to do without any explanations? He's the one who is in control and he knows what he's doing. If God wanted you in that job, he would have made a way. If he wanted you with that partner, he would have made a way. And if he wanted you to have that house, he would have made a way. But listen to me carefully. Nothing that God withholds from you is not necessarily bad or you aren't good enough. It's just that God has way much better for you in store. I'm going to tell y'all this. Let God be in control, because you will end up trying to control your life and end up being in a whole other pathway God didn't initially had set out for you. I want to leave you with these points tonight. Don't get accustomed to the my way mindset, but get accustomed to God's way. What I mean by this is by allowing yourself to die to your fleshly ways of things and align your soul with the Holy Spirit to do what God will is in your life. 2, put God first in everything you do. It could be even the littlest thing. If you learn to put God first in everything you do, the more subject you become to surrender to him fully. You don't let circumstance shape you, because you know God is in front of you, fighting with you. If I can get a bit personal with you, my grandmother passed away this week, and I had two choices, either to allow it to bring me down and crumble me to the point that I can't do anything, or either to trust God that he has a say in everything he does. Yes, I have my times where I grieve and it gets down, but there's still a peace that lies within me that passes my understanding. People may say I'm strong, but can I be real? I'm not. I'm walking in God's strength. And the word is said in 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9 to 10. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my
my trust in my Father who knows everything. Just like Abraham, he was able to trust in God. But not only was he able to trust in God, he had to make a choice to trust and surrender to him. Third point, there is no need to be dependent on yourself when your whole life is already figured out for you. Stop putting the world on your shoulders. We were not created to lean on ourselves. We were created to lean on Christ. Don't make dependency become your God. When it becomes your God, life will forever feel restless and chaotic. Lean on God and not on your own understanding. We may not always understand what God may be doing, but lean on him. Leaning means trusting that there's a reason, and it's for my good. As we come to a close, surrendering plays a big role in letting the author write. And if you haven't got the memo yet on who the author is, it's God. Make letting God have control over your life become second nature. Life becomes less of a burden, and you end up being aligned with God in everything you do. Let God be the author, and you just be the character in the story, waiting for the next thing the author has in store for your next chapter. May everyone stand.
Just a couple of things that I need you to remember for tomorrow. One, school starts at 10. And our Sabbath school coordinator is here and in the house, which means we're gonna start on time.
Amen.
Okay, that's number one. Number two, 11 o'clock service begins at 11 o'clock. And we're gonna start on time, and we're excited about what we have prepared for tomorrow. Our speaker is here this evening, Dr. Washington. If you'll raise your hand. So we already know that the Lord has something special in store for us for tomorrow. There are so many exciting things that are going on. After we finish worshiping together tomorrow, you're welcome. We want you to come and eat with us tomorrow in the cafeteria. After that, at 4 o'clock, what time?
4 o'clock.
Oh, make sure you know this. My students know that I start on time, whether they are there or not. 4 o'clock tomorrow, we'll do our walkthrough and our dedication of Handy Hall. And a parent said to me on Thursday night, they said, I'm ready for extended Camp Danny Davis to end. And I said, I am too. But we made it. We've made it. And so please come tomorrow. We want you to see what God is doing. If you aren't excited tomorrow, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say. But tomorrow afternoon at what time? 4 o'clock, we have a wonderful experience planned for you. When you finish your walkthrough tomorrow, we have a nice reception for you, our green and white reception here at the church after you do your walkthrough. Now, we pack the day, because once you get done there, you have about an hour and a few minutes, and then the choir will begin their concert this tomorrow. And it is going to be more than just an experience. So we want you here, we want to make sure you have a seat and you're ready to enjoy what these young people have been working hard on. I am grateful for Creative Arts Ministry. Thank you. Great things. They really are. I have had the privilege of just walking past the door and hearing them get their minds together and start talking. What you all aren't seeing is some of our, this is crazy now, but some of our shyest young people. Some of the ones that if you're in the classroom with them, we can't get a word out of them. Got up here this evening and come up. They did a fantastic job. So I am so proud, and they always tell me, Miss Rose, we know that you don't love us as much as you love the choir. So not true. So not true. I have a special bag for them. They just haven't seen it yet. It's not finished. When I travel with the choir, those of you who see me know I have this piece of luggage that I carry. I have a new piece of luggage for Creative Arts Ministry. So we're really excited about what God is doing. As I get ready to let you go, I want to point out our Parents Association folk. I want all of those Parent Association people to stand. All of my executive members, Parent Association. There we are. There we are. There are more of you that I'm sure we'll see on tomorrow. Thank you. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for the willingness that you have to sacrifice for our young people and for us. We appreciate you. And before I go, they didn't know I was going to do this, but if you'll turn your eyes all the way to the back middle aisle at the back doors, this is part of our security team. And so if you see them moving around, know that your young people are safe, they are well taken care of, and they are here to make sure that nobody else gets near your children. So we're very grateful for them. I know that there's more than I'm supposed to say. I don't know what it is. Sorry. My USN president is over here at my elbow. Okay, he's reminding me of a very important piece. So as we get ready to go, parents, we know that you want a quiet night in the hotel. Your children want to get away from us and get to you and have a quiet night at the hotel. I see parents shaking their heads, young people. Y'all's people are trying to leave y'all right here. Right here. If you would like to take your child home, please make sure that you communicate with the deans so that we know who's here and who's not here. We need to make sure we know that. We also need them back here on time.
Please.
On time tomorrow. Okay. Y'all hear Miss Martina down here? We need them back on time. So it's a great weekend. We have a lot planned for you. We can't wait for you to experience it with us. The Lord has something special for us this weekend. So can you stand with me one more time and we'll pray together and I'll let you go. Father, we are grateful. We have seen you work in so many ways, especially as you touch the lives of our young people.
Yes.
And so, God, as we separate and go to our hotel rooms, cabins, beds, homes, give us rest this evening. In the morning, God, wake us up fresh and new and ready to experience you. We ask not only that you bless us and keep us, but you give us the ability to share your love with someone else. Bless us this evening, God. Forgive us for our sins. And when you come, come soon. Please save us. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be dismissed. Have a great evening. We'll see you tomorrow.